Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to discuss one very interesting filter for image processing. Okay, so while taking photo of a still object, if your camera has some linear motion, okay, due to some reason your hand just moved a little bit, that time what happens, some kind of blur appears in that captured image, right? Or it might also appear when your hand is still but you are taking photo of a moving object, that time also some blur appears in the captured image, right? That is called motion blur. And in my this video, I am going to discuss how we can introduce this motion blur artificially in our image. Okay, and for this I am going to use if special function. Okay, if special function, if you just explore the documentation, you can understand that it provides us lots of filters, okay, which we can simply apply or convolve with our original image and get some beautiful effects, okay, which are real time, right? Like here, average for moving average filter, Gaussian filter, Laplacian filter, these filters already I have discussed, right? So see here, h equal to f special motion length comma theta is present. So what it does, it returns a filter to approximate once convolved with an image the linear motion of a camera. So kind of it introduces the linear motion of a camera, this kind of effect it introduces in our image artificially. Okay, so here it takes two pieces of argument, one is length, another one is theta. Okay, length specifies the length of the motion and theta specifies the angle of the motion. Okay, suppose in 135 degree you want that your object, your image should be blurred such that it will appear that it is moving at an angle 135 degree. Like that, if you want to specify, you can play with this theta. And length indicates how much, okay, you want to introduce the blur, okay, the length of motion. Okay, if you introduce longer, then it will appear that the object is moving very fast. If you introduce smaller length, then the object is moving slower, kind of that. Okay, so here you can see the example is present. Suppose here we are reading the cameraman.tif, very popular image. Then here we are specifying length as 20, theta as 45 degree. And when we are passing via IM filter function, you can see that this image which is produced, we can clearly understand that it has some 135 degree angle motion, right? So now let us try to implement this in MATLAB, but instead of using IM filter, I'll be using something else. Okay, so here for that I have created one problem statement. Let's try to understand the problem statement first. Filtering can be used to simulate camera motion occurring when the picture is being taken. The if special function can be used to generate a horizontal motion filter. It does not matter horizontal, we can do for any angle as we have seen, but for this particular problem we are going to generate this particular effect, that is motion blur, in horizontal direction, that can be converted with the image using conf2 function. So instead of using IM filter, we have to use conf2 according to this particular problem statement. Use the f special function to generate a horizontal motion filter with the default parameters. So we no need to play with the length and theta. And if you check here the documentation, it is clearly written the default length is 9 and the default theta is 0, which corresponding to horizontal motion of 9 pixel. Okay, so our job is very much simplified, we no need to play with these two parameter, just we need to use this particular f special function, okay, for motion blur. Okay, and the question is that, see, something more is written, apply the filter to the cameraman.tif image and display the result. Use the same argument for conf2 so that the output dimension matches with the original image, because you know while doing convolution the output has different dimension compared to input. But if we use this particular same as argument, that time what will happen, it will be trying to keep same size as of my input. Okay, and the question is, what is the average pixel intensity value of the resulting image, accurate to 2 decimal places? Alright, so let's go to MATLAB and let's start the programming. So here first let me clear this, right? So here what I'll do, clc clear all close all warning of x equal to im read cameraman dot tiff. We are reading the file and im show x. Let us first run this particular part and check whether the image is imported properly or not. Yes. Now, so here h equal to if special, here we will specify motion, right? See, as soon as I write m, it is coming. Just I will press tab and it will appear. I am not specifying raise to parameter because we know that we have to keep that default, right? Now k equal to conv to, because im filter also apply convolution only, that is this is nothing but kernel we have to apply on our original image. Okay, so I'll be specifying x comma h, or you can specify h comma x also, as you know that convolution of x and h is equal to convolution of h and x. Okay, and here I'll be specifying same, because I need to keep the output image having same size as of my input, right? Now what we'll be doing will be displaying in a new figure im show k. Okay, first let me run this. So here we are getting that, but here figure 2 is not showing. Why? We'll be checking that. First let me check size of x. Okay, that is my input image is having this size, and if we check size of k, which is our convolution result, see we are getting same size, right? If we write h comma x, see here 1 comma will be coming, and we'll be doing evaluate selection. Now we'll write size of k, see 1,9. Okay, so what is happening actually, when you are using specifying the parameter as same, that time the first input will be having what size, that size, same size it will try to keep as output. So here conf to, when you are specifying same, then specify the original input image first, then specify the kernel. Okay, right? Now we'll run this, but the figure is not showing. Why? Let us check whose of k. So it is double. Double is not normal data type, because in double 0 is dark and 1 is white, and above 1 everything is white, right? So everything is coming as white. So rather what we can do here, im show uint 8, we will be converting this to unsigned integer 8 bit representation. Okay, and doing evaluate selection. So see, in horizontal direction motion blur is created beautifully. But the question is not finished. The question is asked, what is the average pixel intensity value of the resulting image accurate to 2 decimal place, right? So we will be doing min of, what is my filtered image, k, so k and colon, that is I am receiving this, okay, whole 2 cross 2, not 2 cross 2, m cross n, whatever, 256 cross 256 image will be converted to one single column, right? And we are getting this result. So the correct answer is 117.53, because we need to mention up to 2 decimal place. Okay, so 117.53 is the correct answer for this particular question. So I hope you have understood this, that how you can artificially introduce motion blur in images using this particular f special motion function. And there are 2 input parameters also you can specify, that is length and the angle, right? You can explore those. This particular code I'll be providing in the description box. If you want, you can go through that. Thank you.